is in the Lord.
The Lord is in thee.
Hallelujah. There is one body and one spirit.
There is one hope in God's call to us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all. Down, lying on, tear down, coming after me.
people would like to come forward to come join me up here, that would just be great. Thank you very much. Be showing you things. So you might actually want to be here, not there. So I'm going to be sitting on the ground there. Or I could move back. That too. Nice chair to rest my back on. This is actually kind of nice. Might stay here all morning. So all your compliments just come up, but I'll just. Bishop Laura, you can call me Bishop Laura, or you can call me Laura, you can call me either one, whatever you like. I'm going to talk to you a little bit today about my hat. When I was elected bishop, I got this very cool hat. It's pretty, isn't it? Where did I get it? Some men who dedicate their whole life to praying to Jesus, who live together in the community and seek to pray to Jesus and bring people closer to Jesus. It's a place called the Holy Rood Guild. It's a Holy Rood Monastery, and it's up in Western Massachusetts. And one of the things these men do is they make clothes for church people. So they make clothes for bishops, and they make clothes for priests, and they make this hat. So this is what happened, it looks like. It does look like a flower. Isn't that beautiful? I love when the monks put this beautiful flower on that there. But it kind of looks like a flower anyway. It has a stem and then it kind of blooms like that. So it's kind of a flower and then it has this beautiful flower. What else does it look like? No more answer. What do you think? Any thoughts? Some people say it looks like a kite. Like a kite with a tail. A boat. Oh, I love that. You know, particularly because you have this image of the blue water down here. I picked blue because it makes me think of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Her color is blue. So I always think Mary, Mother of our Lord. So a great woman to remember on Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day to all of you, by the way. So here, and then we have this sort of hat floating on the sea, right? This boat floating on the sea. And bumping along, bumping along.
It's kind of like the song
Row, Row, Row. It's actually showing how old I am. It's a song from an old lady bent off the broomsticks. Some people remember that. Some people said it looks like a tree house. Because these are like the stilts that a tree, or, you know, this might be the tree, and then this is the house. Or a house on stilts, like you sometimes find at the beach, and sometimes the water will come up underneath the house, but it's not a house sitting on dry land, it's actually up on stilts. What it's supposed to be is a flame coming out of my head. I'm not really sure it looks like a flame. But if you think about it, if you look at a candle, there on the candles on the altar, this beautiful candle that's part of our Easter celebration, the Paschal candle. It's this kind of this idea of a flame coming out. I don't think this necessarily looks like a flame. It looks more like water in a flower. But I have an old hat that's starting to get a little tired, and I'm sort of tempted to take colors to it, make it like red and yellow and blue and green, because that actually might, and then put it on, and then it might look like a flame coming out of my head. But one of the things it's supposed to remind me of is the Holy Spirit, who we sometimes think about as a flame. And it's a flame of God's love burning. It's burning inside each one of us. And it wants to burst out and show the world how much God loves us. And God wants us to share that love with others. So I have this flame on my head to remind me that God's love is on fire in my heart. And God wants me to share that love with everybody here and everybody I meet. The other thing my cool hat has, which I really like, is it has these things that are called lappets. I never knew that was me a bishop. But what they actually are for is one stands for the Old Testament and one stands for the New Testament.
so he reminded me of the Bible. When they used to make bishops during the service, they'd put a Bible on the back of their head to remind them to always preach the stories of the scriptures and the good news of Jesus Christ revealed in scriptures. They don't do that anymore. I'm kind of happy about that. But that book can be really heavy. I'm not sure I really want that sitting on my back, even for just a minute. That book is a big book. It's kind of heavy. Could you imagine that sit on my back? No, I'd rather have these. So these remind the Old Testament and the New Testament. Do you guys know any Old Testament stories? There are stories in the beginning of the Bible. Anybody know one in the very beginning? Yes, sir. Noah's Ark, right, yeah. All the words to Noah. He's singing a lot this morning. Yeah, Noah's Ark, one of my favorite stories, right? Very powerful story. Yeah. Other Old Testament stories, stories in the beginning of the Bible, the beginning of the good book. Yeah. Stories of Moses. You guys are awesome. You got Noah, you got Moses, the story of Adam and Eve. Great stories, stories about creation. To remind us that God created the world, God created each one of us, and loves us and touches. And what the Bible does is it tells us stories throughout history of places where people want to share stories of God's love. God's love has always been through, and these sometimes we write some of those stories down. They're written down in the Old Testament, Moses and Noah. Do you guys know any New Testament stories? Anything in the New Testament? Who's the hero of the New Testament? Anybody know? Jesus. Awesome. High five. Awesome. Good job. I was at my church once and I said it begins with a J and they go, Joseph? He's got a big role, but Jesus is the star. Joseph's got a supporting role. So, best supporting actor goes to Jesus. So, and the best actor goes to Jesus. So, Jesus. Do you guys know any stories about Jesus?
You don't know any stories about Jesus?
Yeah. Oh, wow, the story of Jesus on the cross. And then this wonderful story that we're telling now in what we call Easter season about the resurrection. Because Jesus died for our sins and then he comes back to life, this resurrection, this new life. And what that says to us is, your sins are forgiven. My sins are forgiven. All of our sins are forgiven. And God wants us every day to know that we can start over and have a new life. Even if you did something bad or mean yesterday, Jesus says, just I forgive you for that and live a new life today and seek to do good and share my love with everyone. Yeah. So stories of Jesus. So what these lapids do that sit on my head with the flame is they remind me to tell the stories about God's love in the Bible and remind us that those stories help us connect to the stories in each one of your lives about where God loves you. So God's always with you. He's always saying, I love you. He wants you to share that love like a flame. And he always wants you to know he's connected to where we've been, where you are, and where we're all going. Because we want you. It's a whole lot for a very busy hat. A hat that looks really just like a flower. All right, well, good job, guys. We're going to keep going with church, and I think you guys are off to church school, right? Have fun. Enjoy. Thank you all for coming up here. The Lord be with you. Let us pray together. O God, whose Son Jesus is the shepherd of your people, grant that when we hear his voice, we may know him who calls us each by name, and follow where he leads, who with you in the Holy Spirit lives and reigns. Forever and ever. Amen.
first reading was from Acts. Now in Joppa, there was a disciple whose name is Tabitha, which is Greek for Dorcas. She was devoted to good works and acts of charity. At that time, she became ill and died. When they had washed her, they laid her in a room upstairs. Since Lydda was near Joppa, the disciples who heard Peter was there sent two men to him with a request. Please come to us without delay. So Peter got up and went with them, and when he arrived, they took him in the room upstairs. All the widows beside him weeping and showing tunics and other clothing that Dorcas had made while she was with them. Peter put all of them outside, and then he knelt down and prayed. He turned to the body and said, "Tabitha, get up." Then she opened her eyes, and seeing Peter, she sat up. He gave her his hand, and he helped her up. Then, calling the saints and the widows, he showed her to be alive. This became known throughout Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. Meanwhile, he stayed in Joppa for some time with a certain Simon, a tanner. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us sing Psalm 23 together.
Their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of water of life, and God will wipe every tear from their eyes. The word of the Lord.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
be here. I'm seeing lots of people I know, which is really exciting. As some of you know, I was director in St. James in Danbury for about 7.5 years before I was elected bishop. So spent some time in St. Paul's in Brookfield during my time in Danbury, and then so seeing some old friends and some new friends, and seeing the Wheelers in the back, Jim and Carol, yes, so it's great to have you guys here. It's great to be with all of you on this day, worshiping the Lord Christ, and confirmations, receptions, reaffirmations. The party continues in the Easter season. This is the fourth Sunday of the Easter season, which is called Good Shepherd Sunday by most folks, because no matter whether we're in, we have a three-year election year. I don't know if you all are aware of that. There's no particular reason why you would be or need to be, except if you're a preacher. And it's we do a cycle A, a cycle B, and a cycle C. And no matter where we are in A, B, or C, the lessons on the fourth Sunday always remind us that Jesus is our good shepherd. So I started thinking about Jesus as the good shepherd in preparation for coming here. And I started thinking about all of the people who have shepherded me in my journey and brought me to a deeper understanding of who the Good Shepherd is in my own life. And then I thought about a passage that I read in a book by a man named N.T. Wright, Tom Wright, who wrote a book called Paul for Everyone. Love the title. He also wrote Mark for Everyone, Luke for Everyone, Matthew for Everyone. Sort of on a theme here. What Tom says in this book, Paul for Everyone, is he says, God's kingdom, you see, isn't about food and drink, but about justice, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Justice, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. So then I started thinking about people that have brought me closer to the Good Shepherd and the ways they've done that through bringing me to a deeper understanding of God's peace, God's joy, and God's justice. How have they shepherded me in my understanding and my claiming of my role in that good and holy work, the work of the Good Shepherd? The first person I thought of is a person who shepherded me into a deeper understanding of God's peace. I grew up in a home that was very supportive and very loving, and yet had no idea what this call to priesthood was about. My dad was a chemical engineer, my mom worked in business, and their youngest child coming home from school and saying, I feel called to ordained ministry, was not anything in their worldview. And then I went to church, and I met with one of the priests in my home church and said, I feel like I have this deep relationship with Jesus. And I feel like I'm being called to share that faith in a way that sees the church as a vehicle by which I could be supported, and a way that I could find and create spaces of support and encouragement for others to live their Christian faith. And she didn't say anything except, tell me more. Tell me your story. Tell me who Jesus is to you, and tell me how you believe God is calling to share God's love with others. And then she gently shepherded me into reading books, going on retreats, pointing me in direction of other Christians who could help me understand their journey and help me make sense of my own. The peaceful space that she created for me helped me claim my understanding of who the Good Shepherd is for me, and taught me how to create space, I hope, for others to explore the same. Joy.
Who are the people that have shepherded me in an understanding of joy? As I prayed about this week, I kept thinking of all the times in my life when I've absolutely delighted in the Lord in ways that have called me to want to dance or sing with delight. And yet the story I kept coming back to was a story about my friend Mary, who invited me to take a course with her on peace building. And part of the coursework involved visiting a men's prison. Now, I know a lot of prison chaplains, and they've all invited me to come visit with them in their ministry settings. And for some reason, I'm always too busy to fill out the paperwork when, if I'm honest with myself, it was fear. It was fear of the unknown and the unfamiliar that kept me from filling out that paperwork and going into prison. And yet my friend Mary had a trump card, coursework. I am nothing if I'm not a nerd. So if somebody's going to say to me, this is a course requirement, I'm going to do it. And the next thing I know, I'm in a maximum security prison in California, sitting in a room with men who are going to be released from prison in the next 6 months, at an Alcoholics Anonymous meeting, hearing these men talk about the choices they made before they went into prison, how they found in prison this recovery community that was non-judgmental and supportive and invited them to know new life while in prison. And they knew that that was a tool that could support them in their journey when they were released, when they would be tempted by old ways and old habits. This supportive community would guide them in their new life. They had so much joy in their hearts, it was contagious. And that is one of the places that I have learned about joy. Because joy is found not only in the places where we find dance and song, but also in the places where people are free to live into their new life. And sometimes those spaces are in places we might not even imagine going. And yet, what joy has for us, God has for us to find in those places. Sometimes joy is found in places where we might imagine we're going to be a bit uncomfortable. And yet God says, this is where I am. Come join my joy. Justice. As I prayed about persons who have shepherded me in understanding justice in this past week, and the justice of the Good Shepherd, I found myself going to a very difficult place. Because I found myself going to a place where my shepherds have been people who have been harmed by injustice. It also took me to a very political place. And I want to be very clear to say, my personal feelings are not ones I'm asking you to keep or claim. And yet for me, I just say, after the shootings in Sandy Hook Elementary School, I found myself feeling that the voice of justice that God was calling me to proclaim was one that said, we need to stop gun violence and seek better gun laws within this country and within this state. I own that as my personal conviction and my personal call to justice. And I believe that that work brings me closer to what the Good Shepherd is calling me to claim in my life. I never imagined in a gazillion years that I would be standing in front of the White House with a microphone at my lips, speaking against gun violence and for building a community of love and safety for all. And that was the voice of justice that I was shepherded into in my journey. On this day, I invite you to ask yourselves, who are the people that have shepherded you to a deeper understanding of God's peace, God's joy, and God's justice? And I want to thank you for the ways you have been that shepherd for others. Our work continues, and with the support of the Good Shepherd, we can all be about this good and holy work. Amen. The candidates will now be presented.
I present these persons for confirmation, for reception into the Episcopal Church, and for reaffirmation of baptismal vows.
Would you please stand? Your line is in the bulletin, and your answer to this one is I do. Do you see where we all are? We're in the middle of the page there. All right? So I ask you, do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil?
I do.
Do you renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do. From God's grace, I will follow him as my Savior and Lord.
Outstanding. Now I'm going to ask all of us to stand. And if we agree with this statement, our answer is we will. So I ask all of us gathered here today, will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support these persons in their life in Christ?
We will.
Then let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. I ask you, do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended to death. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I believe in God's help.
We persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord.
I will do God's help.
You proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ.
I will do God's help.
You seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself.
I will do God's help.
You strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being.
I will do God's help.
Let us now pray for these persons who have renewed their commitment to Christ.
Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open their hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send them into the world and witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We invite other prayers and thanksgivings at this time.
Thank you, God, for bringing us to this wonderful church. Thank you for our wonderful pastor and for this wonderful day.
Thank you that you fill us with your joy each and every day.
I pray that with the power of the Holy Spirit, those are God confirmed today, they receive that power and use that power for their life to diminish whatever the call of the God they have in their life, in the lives of those who will be confirmed today.
Thank you, Lord, for the mothers who shepherd their children.
Thank you for the peace that flows from the church.
Almighty God, we thank you that by the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, you have overcome sin and brought us to yourself. And that by the sealing of your Holy Spirit, you have bound us to your service. Renew in these, your servants, the covenant you made with them at their baptism. Send them forth in the power of that Spirit to perform the service you set before them. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated. What will happen now is each candidate will come forward for confirmation, for reaffirmation, or for reception. If you were a sponsor or a shepherding person in this person's journey, I invite you to stand in place. So that the only persons that will be coming forward are the persons to be confirmed or received or reaffirmed their vows. But if you are here as a sponsor or a shepherd or support person, we'd be delighted if you could stand and in place and witness to this joy-filled moment. Folks are going to come forward one at a time and will either stand or kneel, whatever their preference is. So. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Linda with your Holy Spirit. Empower her for your service and sustain her all the days of her life. Amen. Thank you.
Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Edith Elaine with your Holy Spirit. Empower her for your service. Sustain her all the days of her life. Amen. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Ronald J. with your Holy Spirit. Empower him for your service and sustain him all the days of his life. Amen. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant George William with your Holy Spirit. Empower him for your service and sustain him all the days of his life. Amen. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Linda Ann with your Holy Spirit. Empower her for your service and sustain her all the days of her life. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant William Timothy with your Holy Spirit. Empower him for your service and sustain him all the days of his life. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Max Kenneth with your Holy Spirit. Empower him for your service and sustain him all the days of his life. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Elizabeth Ann with your Holy Spirit. Empower her for your service and sustain her all the days of your life. J. Allen, we recognize you as a member of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. Amen. Polymerie, we recognize you as a member of one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep. Mary Beth, we recognize you as a member of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. Amen. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Laura Corinne with your Holy Spirit. Empower her for your service and sustain her all the days of your life. Amen. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Jenna Lee with your Holy Spirit. Empower her for your service and sustain her all the days of the month. Amen. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Christian Joseph with your Holy Spirit. Empower him for your service and sustain him all the days of his life. Amen. Strengthen, O Lord, your servant Patrick Dawson with your Holy Spirit. Empower him for your service and sustain him all the days of his life. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, let your fatherly hand ever be over these your servants. Let your Holy Spirit ever be with them, and so lead them in the knowledge and obedience of your word, that they may serve you in this life, and dwell with you in the life to come. Amen. Amen. Would you please stand? May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
Amen.
If we pray with another, the peace of our prison.
Thank you.
buddy. Oh, is she here?
She's watching him.
Oh, she's too funny.
Hi, Eliza.
Where is she? She probably was texting me this morning,
Grace to you and welcome in the name of our risen Savior, Jesus Christ. What a joy it is to celebrate this day of Holy Confirmation with all of you and with our Bishop Laura. Thank you for being here. Indeed, this is a celebration which will continue through the Great Thanksgiving. There are communion instructions in the bulletin. Welcome to you all. If you're visiting for the first time, we're so pleased that you're here with us, and we hope that you will all join us downstairs in Crocker Hall for refreshments after this time together, where we can continue to visit with Laura and one another. And the vestry, as a reminder, will be meeting with Laura in the guild room for lunch and conversation from 12:30 until approximately 2 o'clock. So please remember to join us for that. And next Sunday, we will probably have another full church because we have 4 baptisms and First Communion, so please come early to get your seats for next week. A blessed Mother's Day to you all, whether you are a biological mother, as it's defined that way, or a spiritual mother. Welcome to this celebration of the gift of motherhood, the vocation of motherhood, and please feel free to take one of those beautiful pink carnations after you receive communion as you go back to your pew. And also remember that we have prayer servants that are pleased to pray with you if you need prayer for yourself or anyone else. And they're located in the hallway to my left right here. Ascribe to the Lord the honor to his name, bring offerings, and come into his courts.
His love for me.
Celebration continues this day with the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly, we're bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of the Lord. Subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks, he newly broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit. Be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And on the last day, bring us, all your saints, into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
Hallelujah, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat the feast.
gifts of God for you, the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed upon him in your hearts by faith.
No place I'd rather be. No place.
be. No place I'd rather be. No place I'd rather be. Here in your love, here in your love. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain.
You are the light. the truth the way. So here I stand with you. I have done all my own. My hands are lifted high, so you can take control. And I will follow you into the great unknown. Oh Lord, just give me strength to live for you all alone. I keep my eyes on you.
Thanks to God for the divine gift of motherhood in all its diverse forms. Let us pray for all the mothers among us today, for our own mothers, for those living, and for those who have passed away, for the mothers who loved us, and for those who fell short of loving us fully, for all who hope to be mothers someday, and for those whose hope to have children has been frustrated, for all mothers who have lost children, for all women and men who have mothered others in any way, those who have been our substitute mothers, and we who have done so for those in need, and for the earth that bore us and provides us with our sustenance. We pray all of this in the name of our God, our great and loving Mother. Amen. Let us pray together our post-communion prayer. Gracious Father,
We give you praise and thanks for this holy communion of the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the pledge of our redemption. We pray that you bring the cross forgiveness of our sins, strengthen our weakness, and everlasting salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
May the peace of God that passes all understanding fill your hearts and minds with the knowledge and love of God, through his Son, Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, be with you this day and remain with you always.
Amen.
Christ, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.